Hello, my name is Ryan, but you can call me Repeat. I make stuff in SRPG Studio as a hobby. If you aren't familiar, SRPG Studio is a game maker engine designed for making Fire Emblem-like strategy RPGs. It's probably best known as the engine behind the Vesteria Saga series, though there are plenty of amazing games being made with it all the time. Today, I'm going to talk about a game mechanic I've implemented, which I'm calling autoberserk. The idea comes from a video by Excelblem, which I'm going to link in the description. In that video, Excelblem described a cursed weapon along the lines of a devil axe, where it's very powerful, but has a significant drawback. In this case, its drawback is that it turns the wielder into a green unit. Absolutely incredible idea. As soon as I saw the video, I started working on adding this mechanic to SRPG Studio, and I finished it just a few days later. That was last November. A discerning viewer may have noticed that it's not 2022 anymore. Truth be told, I'm not a YouTuber, and I don't know how to edit videos beyond placing some clips together end to end. I'd written a whole script of ways I wanted to demonstrate this mechanic in a polished way, but I eventually realized I was never going to learn the editing skills needed to do that, at least not anytime remotely soon. So this is going to be a lot more straightforward than what I was going to go with before, but I think it's actually better this way, because this way, the video will actually get made. So let's get into it. Here we have our Myrmidon, Jeffrey, who is up against an armored unit. He doesn't normally stand much of a chance here. When I attack the soldier, you can see he can't even damage the guy with the ordinary sword, not to mention he has a shaky hit rate. On the other hand, he cleanly one-rounds the soldier if he uses the sword we're all here for, which I've called Excalibur. I can check its stats and see that it hugely outclasses the short sword. But who cares about how good the sword is when we're here for its drawback? In Excelblum's video, the auto berserk status goes into effect when the unit equips the cursed weapon. I've made it work a little differently here. See, by default, SRPG Studio plays a little fast and loose with the idea of equipped weapons, basically just treating the weapon at the top of the user's inventory as the equipped one in all circumstances. So instead of the weapon's neat little effect occurring upon equipping the weapon, I decided to make the effect occur if the user engages in combat while using the weapon. As you can see, after that round of combat, Jeffrey is now green. I can't control him like I can with the rest of the party, and I'll end my turn right here to show that he now acts on his own phase. The Auto Berserk weapon doesn't have any special effects if the unit isn't on the player's faction, by the way. It behaves like any other sword for allies and enemies. It kinda has to, especially for allies. In the default settings of this plugin, because this plugin does indeed have some customizable settings, the effect is reverted at the end of the map. However, if, as a friend, your units are replaceable, I've left in an option to disable that if you're a cruel creator. In that case, at the end of the map, an auto-berserked unit would be treated as if they'd left the party, which is distinct from death in SRPG Studio terms. Let's show off some more features of this auto-berserk weapon. Here, Jeffrey has already berserked himself on an enemy. He's wielding what I guess I'll call the first iteration of Excalibur. This sword's version of the curse will be lifted when the sword itself breaks. Here, I'll end turn and let him run out its uses on his phase. While this is going on, notice that I've changed his inventory. Instead of a mediocre short sword, he has another weapon that should be very, very tempting for the AI to use. However, I've made it so the AI will always prioritize continuing to use their auto berserk weapon. I think they would often want to anyway, given that these auto berserk weapons should be very powerful themselves. But I figure I might as well make sure. I'll go ahead and say now that you may not want the protagonist of your game to be able to use the auto berserk weapon. I can foresee plenty of kinds of softlocks if you let that happen. As you can see, Jeffrey has finally returned to his senses, and not a moment too soon. But maybe I should have kept some blue units around to help him now that he's free. Let's move on to Let's call this an OutRealm where the Excelliver is just a bit different. Kids love OutRealms these days. This version of Excelliver has a different version of its curse, too. It's significantly kinder, I think. For this one, rather than the curse breaking when the sword does, the curse instead wears off over time. In this example, the curse lasts for 2 turns, including the turn that the unit got berserked. So let's see it play out. Now, I'm not going to pretend this is necessarily a more lenient curse. What's stopping you from making it wear off after 5 turns instead? Or 20? Or 100? Not me. Now let's look at the third and final version of the Excelliver. This one's iteration of the curse is particularly nasty. The curse will not lift until the unit kills a certain number of enemies while under the curse, 5 in this example. Even if the weapon is really strong, unless it also buffs the unit's defenses, this is probably the most dangerous curse out of all of them. It forces you to go into a lot of combat. What about the flip side? What if Marth was right? What if, as a friend, this unit is irreplaceable? As you just saw, I've also made it so certain kinds of status-curing staves can remove the auto-berserk curse. This was probably the hardest part to implement of all of it, believe it or not. So that's my implementation of auto-berserk. The effect is always the same, turning a blue unit green, but you have plenty of options when it comes to how the curse can get lifted. And I do mean it when I say you have options, because this plugin is public. I make tons of plugins for SRPG Studio that I share with the community, and this is a pretty interesting one to add to the collection. My GitHub, containing all of my plugins, including this one, is linked in the description as well. If you watched Excelblem's video, you might be wondering about the mechanics I omitted from that video. The what happens if you ignore the weapon kind of shitposty stuff from that video is where my interest in the concept falls off. There are plenty of up and downsides to making an auto-berserk weapon tempting as is without having to punish people. In fact, I think this implementation is kind of a plausible idea for a standard SRPG. So I'm sticking with what I have here. And I mean, the code is public, so if you want to make additions to it, then go ahead. I was pushed to finally work on this video because of a wrist injury keeping me from playing games that take 2 hands, and luckily I can record with no hands. I can't wait to play Fire Emblem Engage eventually. My special edition literally arrived while I was recording the audio for this video. That was when the email got to me. I'm thinking I'll try to figure out a claw grip for my Joy-Cons, but if I can't, then I get to go back to playing Vesteria Saga 2, so it's a win-win. Once again, Excelblem's video is in the description. Thanks so much for watching. So that's auto-berserk. Berserk. As you can see, Jeffrey has finally returned to his senses, and not a moment too soon. But maybe I should have kept some blue... This isn't for me.